This screencast is for the Sun Earth Moon System Lesson 5, discussing investigating lunar phases. We talked about the moon today in class, and we mentioned that it is a sphere that reflects the sun's light. And no matter where the moon is positioned in its path around the sun, only half of the moon is illuminated at any one time. So the apparent shape of the moon in our sky depends on how much of the moon's illuminated side is visible from Earth. So it all depends on our perspective. Lunar phases are the predictable cycle of changes that occur to the moon's apparent shape. And I have circled the word apparent because we remember that the moon's not actually getting smaller or bigger, it's just that it's covered with a shadow more or less of the time. So, new moon is when the moon passes between the sun and the earth and only the dark side is visible to us. So, it's actually there, but it's just kind of dark in the sky. A full moon is the opposite. This is when earth is between the moon and the sun and the moon's entire illuminated side is visible. So, you had to draw pictures of the phases of the moon using the illustrations in your textbook, and we discussed how the moon goes through this phase or goes through these phases every 27.3 days. And you'll have to know these phases and be familiar with them, be able to identify a picture of them and name the phase on your test. So you might want to make some flashcards of these phases. So the moon can be the moon's orbit can be understood in two ways. First, there is what we call the sidereal month. And this is the time it takes for the moon to orbit Earth one complete revolution, which is 27.3 days. This is the number that we've mentioned before. Another way to think about the moon's orbit is the time it takes between successive repetitions of the same lunar phase. So, for example, from one new moon to the next new moon. This is called a synodic month because it's not exactly the same length of time as the sidereal month. The synodic month takes 29.5 days. And we discuss this because as the moon is orbiting the Earth, okay, and the time it takes it to come all the way around is 27.3 days. This is a sidereal month, okay? But as it's doing this, okay, this Earth here is also moving. And so for us to see that the moon is coming all the way around, we won't see the same phase at this place because of the movement of the Earth. So the moon has to move a little bit more to get to another new moon because now we have to have another way of lining up the Earth, the moon, and the sun. So this is the difference between a sidereal month and a synodic month. Basically, you just need to know that they're different times. They're not the same length. Okay, the other terms that you're going to need to know that I think will help you with remembering the phases is knowing the difference between waxing, which is when the right side of the moon is illuminated, and the difference between that and waning, which is when the left side of the moon is illuminated.